Good day, Derby fans. I'm River Rain, and I am here with Sven Will I Be Famous. And you are watching the 2019 WFTDA European Continental Cup, brought to you live from Helsinki, Finland, by the Kallio Rolling Rainbow and the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. So, we have got Kallio taking on Central City. Kallio are from Helsinki, Finland, and they are coming into this tournament the number third seed. They're currently ranked 36th in the WFTDA. Central City is coming in seeded number 6 and ranked number 55. And we are going to go to the rosters. So, for Kallio playing in the black, we have number 110, Satupusa, 113, L. 1-9, Kati Schrödinger. Number 2, Aika Helppo. 2-1, Shenanigans. 2-7, Yi Karpov. 3, Koti. 3-0-1, Minna. 3-1, Kamasuttura. 4-1-0, Vattuvimma. 4-9, Machu Picchu. 5-7, Lionheart. 6-0, KO. 8-0, Mu. And number 9, Teabag.
And skating in the pink for Central City, we have number 10, Bonnie Massacre. Number 12, Annie Smack. 19 is Victoria Kudawu. Number 197, Maz Scara. Number 24, Millie Idol. Number 29 is Harris. Number 3077 is Mim the Merciless. 42 is Gemma Harvey. 434, Dr. Knock. 510, Not Sorry Laurie. 707, Jelly Mean. 85, Roald Dahl. 895, L. 909 Treble and 99 Western Superclair. And obviously we'll have to distinguish which L we're talking about here, given that both teams have an L today.
Oh yes, they do. So that's going to be interesting. Let's run through the officials roster as well. So on skates, it's pretty miffed. Connie, Restless Bitch Face, Speed Be- No, sorry, my mistake. That's the non-skating officials. Oh, my bad. Pretty Miffed, Connie, Restless Bitch Face, Speedy Kamalesa, Fester, Kaiser Gerze, Luna Kisanen, Strange Edge, Liz Frizzle, and Mimi First.
And our skating officials, we've got Head Ref Baff, Genuine, Major Buzzkill, Victoria Velociraptor, Caps Lock, Danny Aurelio, and Total Miscall. And we've got about 30 seconds to get into this game, game 3, here at the WFTDA European Continental Cup, as we said, live from Helsinki in Finland. I hope you're tuning in all around the world. I hope you're getting on the Twitter and letting us know what you think about this all. Hope you're all set for another great game. We've had two so far brilliantly, and we're ready to go with, it looks like, Not Sorry Laurie for Central City. Already through with lead, and that is Kamasutura for Kallio, just being rolled back to the turn 3-4 apex. Not Sorry Laurie now in on the first scoring trip, just getting bounced around as we've got Kamasutura now out of the pack, chasing up Not Sorry Laurie with the call off. 2 points go on the board for Central City in this first jam. Kallio shut out, 30 seconds of play gone.
We're off to a good and fast start here. 2 points to get us started. On the line for the next jam, we have L from Central City jamming against Yi Karpov in the black for Kallio. That was the 5 seconds.
4-on-4 in the pack, all huddled on the jam line. Both jammers going for the same space. It's L for Central City is the first to make some headway into the pack. Bonnie Massacre and Gemma Harvey just doing a great job holding up Yi Karpov at the back of the pack as we get our first penalty of the game. It is being picked up by its move from Kallio and lead to L from Central City.
Smooth dodging by L there.
Four-point pickup by L for Central City, and another Kallio blocker has gone to the penalty box. So we're going to be starting off with a reduced Kallio line up with just Watavima and KO lining out for Kallio. And it looks like we have got that's Cutie and Dr. Knock for Central City lining up. Everyone huddled on the jam line. Dr. Knock makes the first moves, but it's Cutie with the rollback. Oh, sorry, Watavima, sorry, with the rollback.
Cutie trying to get past on the inside line is shut down by the Central City pivot. Oh, another recycling. Watavima taking Dr. Knock all the way back.
Some of the Kallio blockers coming back now. Mu coming back to the to join the fray. Followed by Kathy Schrodinger, the captain. Now empty penalty box. Kallio with a full lineup. Let's see if they can actually get Cutie through the pack.
It's been almost a minute of gameplay and no lead. Yes, there we go.
Dr. Knock for Central City picks up lead. Tight in turn two, Dr. Knock through the 4 points. We've had a star pass. That looks like it is to KO for Kallio.
Yeah, KO coming in on the scoring pass, and that was the call-off. So, three jams in, all three lead for Central City. No lead for Kallio, no points for Kallio just yet. So, could we be seeing another upset?
It's early in the game, but I think Kallio are going to just find the feet. Obviously, this is their home floor, so this is their venue that they're used to. Let's see if that obviously helps them out when they get into the stride of the game. I think they'll just be testing out Central City as we get Gemma Harvey. Looks like picks up a four-on penalty straight off the bat. And we get another lead now for Central City with Western Superclair. Hot on the heels is Teabag from Kallio. The pack just rolling around now, trying to get a bit of speed. Kallio holding the front, just trying to get that pack pace up.
Looked like it could have been, yes, the very first point on the board for Kallio. Teabag just snuck right in before the call-off to pick up a single point.
Central City picked up a point as well. So Kallio picked up 3 points in that one. Central City picked up 1 point. So 10-point differential, but only 13 plays three.
Yeah.
As we got Not Sorry Laurie lining up for Central City, and it is going to be Pusa for Kallio.
Multi-layer penalty assessed on
Mascara, I think, is picking up that multiplayer. Yes, it is Mascara. Yes. But Pusa, however, already taken back to the jam line, going to start the initial assault again on this pack as we get Gemma Harvey released from the penalty box. Going to come back and give some offense for Not Sorry Laurie. First lead.
First lead for Kallio. Oh. KO takes out some of the Central City defense, but they reform right around Pusa's, keeping Pusa contained down in the back. Meanwhile, we have Not Sorry Laurie pushing the Kallio defense up front, and there we go, out of the pack.
So Kallio being allowed to score another 4 points now, just starting to get back into the game. Nearly 6 minutes, or just over 6 minutes played so far.
Yeah, sometimes you just need to get into it, shake out the nerves, the first couple of jams, just feel out the opposition. I suspect we'll see Kallio really come into their home team track advantage as the game goes.
And we've got now L for Central City jamming against Kama Satura, who's just broken through for lead, spinning round on the exit of turn one. now coming up on the initial scoring pass. It looks like the L tried the star pass and there was a dropped star.
Yeah.
But is now through, completed the initial pass. Star is back on.
Looks like Kallio's gonna run this. L out on a scoring pass. But Kamasutra working on the second scoring pass. Looks like the bench for Kallio is giving the signal to keep going, keep going, keep going.
Yeah, I think so. Kallio are going to monopolize on when they've got lead, when they've got the momentum going their way, and try and get the points. But at the minute, Kamasutra has just been held in that pack a bit too long. Mm. And obviously, you don't want Central City outscoring you when you've got the control, when you've got the lead.
Exactly.
Especially so early on in the game.
But that was a 7-point jam for Kallio, but 8 points picked up by Central City. That brings us to a score of 21 for Central City in the lead and 14 points picked up by Kallio. It's Yi Karpov up against Dr. Knock.
Dr. Knock making the most moves first at the front of the pack. Yi Karpov just being held up as a three wall at the back. And now we've got Dr. Knock breaking through for lead. Yi Karpov just gambled there, stepping back to track. Looks like it was clear on the outside, so able to get around those blockers, but still being held up at the front now.
And the Central City defense has Yi Karpov on lockdown. But meanwhile, Dr. Knock is in the back, keeping all the Kallio blockers occupied. So there's not a lot of help to get from the teammates.
Yeah, there's just Millie Idle dropped back for Central City, trying to open up some space for Dr. Knock.
Oh, look at Yi Karpov just sort of moving that tripod in the turn.
So this jam's now turned into a test of strength as both jammers are just trying to push through the walls. Yi Karpov has managed to get through, completes the initial pass for Kallio. So we see Dr. Knock just calling off the jam now before Yi Karpov can get in and get any more points on the board. Another four go up for Central City, just stretching that gap to 11 points. Still coming up with 9.5 minutes and almost 10 minutes of the game played. And we've not really got large, like high scores right now, 14 players, 25.
Yeah, and all the jams have been low scoring. It's been, what, 3 passes at most? Not even 2 passes.
Yeah, and we've got like 7 jams so far. And we're back with Western Superclare 4, Central City against QT 4, Kallio. And again, we've gone to this very slow and tight pack. Western Superclare looks like she's broken free of the Kallio blockers first, but then gets reabsorbed. Turn one has picked up lead though. So Western Superclare in control of the jam for Central City.
And a star pass by on the Kallio side.
And there was a star pass to Lionheart, but Western Superclare shuts down the jam before Lionheart gets a chance to even get the star on the helmet. Mm. And we'll give a shout out to Rydell Skates, the proud sponsor of the 2019 WFTDA Playoffs and Championships.
Right on. It is going to be Not Sorry Laurie taking on Teabag.
Teabag just being wrestled off the inside by Jellymean. But Jellymean stays up front, ready to catch Teabag alongside Victoria Kudawu. And that is Millie Idle. Now we've got Not Sorry Laurie through, picks up lead for Central City.
Another pass for Not Sorry Laurie.
And Wat Duvima picks up a cut track as a blocker. So Kallio's defense just reduced slightly as Not So Lorry tries to duck underneath Moo.
And that last minute star pass went to KO, and that was also the forced the call off, as KO was out of the pack and coming in on scoring pass. So far into the game, Central City have had 7 leads, and Kallio has only taken the lead twice.
And we're going to see L for Central City against Pusa for Kallio. L managed to just use the advantage of having the Central City wall at the back to skip through, but now being recycled by Lionheart all the way back to where she started, back to the jam line. Pusa, though, just being held up greatly by Harris. Supported by Bunny Massacre now. Pusa not being given anywhere to go. Watuvima comes from the box, tries to run offense, but just gets stopped solidly by Bunny Massacre. Now trying to open up the inside line for Pusa. Bunny Massacre picks up the multiplayer block as part of that. And Pusa's finally able to muscle the way through the inside of turn one, just knocking treble down. Picks up lead for Kallio. L also out about half a lap behind, catching the pack now. Kallio shuts down the jam before L can get in. 2 points going up for Kallio.
That means the score sits at Central City with 32 points versus Kallio 16 points. Oh, a neat 16 point differential.
Doctor not coming to the jam line right as 5 seconds was called and the whistle blew. Going up against Kamasatura. And it's Kamasatura that has got lead rolling around the front of the pack to pick up lead for Kallio. Star pass to Mascara, number 197, star in hand. Still showing the pivot stripe on your screen right now.
Kallio loses the defender to the box.
Now we've got Mascara out with the star going on. And it's Kallio's turn to shut down the jam before Central City can get in. 4 points for Kallio, starting to inch this back. 20 players, 32 now. Central City with the lead. 15 minutes of the first period of this game through the WFTDA European Continental Cup. Gone already.
It's been going fast here. And I'm loving that I'm not quite seeing the games I'm expecting to see, at least in the beginning.
Yeah, and speaking of the games we're seeing now, we get down Western Superclair off the line quickly, picks up lead for Central City. Yi Karpov following half a lap behind. Both jammers coming up on the pack. Western Superclair gets the shutout, but four points gone up for Central. Just waiting for a quick check of the box there from the jammer referee. So we're getting lots of quick jams now in the last couple where we're getting some, as I say, score it and shut out.
Yeah.
So again, I think now we're finding the teams establishing the tactics that they want to use as we go through this first period, especially with such a low score differential. Not Sorry Lorry and Cutie both again going for the same spot through that pack.
Cutie trying to muscle through in the middle of the tripod, but the Central City defense is not budging particularly much here in the back.
Yeah, that's Victoria Kudewu and Jellymean just holding, being braced. I think it's by Mascara. Doing a great job of actually not giving up much movement at all. Too cutey. And we've got lead for Not Sorry Lorry for Central City.
Central Not sorry, Laurie, out of the pack with 4 points. Kutti still on the initial. Oh, wait, there we go. That's a star pass to KO. The Kallio star is out of the pack, and that's a call off.
And again, Central City just shutting down Kallio. They're getting the star passes off, but they're not getting a chance to actually get that new jammer involved in the jam. And they're just shutting them down. Obviously, you know, it's just moving them further away from Kallio, and obviously, again, just burning some clock, burning some energy. 43 points of Central City now, plays 20 for Kallio.
And on track, we have L for Central City going up against Teabag for Kallio. And it is Teabag on the outside who picks up lead. Central City have stashed a star. L is still the active jammer, but star in hand, trying to either get through or make a sneaky star pass.
Star pass has happened.
There we go.
And it has gone to, it looks like it is Treble. First time we've seen Treble take the star so far. And Treble is through for the first scoring trip. Skips round Aika Helpo, back into the center of the pack, just going around the outside of turn one, but is caught and bumped. And that is by Minna. Just takes Treble back to the crowd straight.
We're back in a standstill in turn one, going into the apex here. Down to the slow grind here. Teabag working the Central City defense in the back of the pack. Not really. Nobody's moving anybody here.
Yeah, we've gone back to that situation where nobody's moving. Teabag still lead, has control of the jam here. So, you know, and we're going to get Teabag calling off the jam. We got stuck there. Both jammers not able to move the pack, and we'd gone from quite a nice rolling pace of the game to a very stalemate again.
But it's an interesting dynamic switch to see these team going from this really fast games where they just go in, grab points, call off to both.
So we're going to get a timeout call from Kallio. Thought that was evident by the way they all huddled around the bench and didn't bother lining up.
So I'm getting some lovely information from our producer, Riggs, that Western Superclair has 100% lead percentage so far. And I'd like to take this opportunity to talk to you about the S1 helmets. The S1 Lifer Visor Helmet offers next level protection. Go to s1helmets.com to check it out. The WFTDA also would like to thank Atom Skates, Antic Skates, Quick Bearings, Powerdyne, Radar Wheels, Rydell, and S1 Helmets for helping sponsor this tournament and making this lovely 2019 postseason a reality. So if you have anything to say to us, come on and join the party at talk to WFTDA. That's hashtag talk to the numeral 2 WFTDA.
So we're ready to go now, and that is Pusa lined up against Dr. Nock. Both jammers just consumed by the pack right now as we roll into turn one. Dr. Nock trying to find a way through. Now we're separating into two distinct packs, or two distinct groups, I should say. Only one pack. Dr. Knock at the front, got Maz Scara running some offense, also trying to hold that pack together. So the pack looks like it's at the front right now. And we get Pusa burst through, picks up lead for Kallio. Dr. Knock now breaking the pack and getting out. So Pusa with lead. Looks going to make the call off. Call off made. 1 point picked up by Kallio. 0 for Central City.
So Pusa still sitting on a 100% lead. Let's see how long we can keep that streak going. But we still have plenty of time on the clock. We have 9 minutes left on this first half. And still a whole second half coming up.
So we've got Kama Satura and Western Super Clare. And again, we've gone to this very bunched up start, making the jammers really work for this initial 20 feet of track. But it is Kama Satura who gets through, picks up lead for Kallio. Western Super Clare removes the start, is going to look for, I think that is Gemma Harvey. I think we're in the, yeah, Gemma Harvey with a stripe. And the star pass is made to Gemma Harvey, who is now out of the pack and chasing down Kama Satura, who's already through for 4 points. Gemma Harvey now into the pack as Kama Satura is just being recycled.
It looks like Kama Satura is gonna run this a bit. Kallio trying to capitalize on all the time they have lead, and we have a cut track penalty assessed to Gemma Harvey. Power jam for Kama Sutra for Kallio.
Still 4-on-4 in the pack, so Kama Sutra still got to deal with 4 Central City blockers. However, now can have full offense if they require. And we've got a cut track penalty, I believe that was for Kama Satura. So we're going to get a jammer swap. It looks like Gemma Harvey's time was elapsing anyway, so I think we might see the full 30 for Kama Satura.
Quite likely, quite likely. Gemma Harvey trying to move the Kallio defense down the straightaway. One to beat, and Gemma Harvey is out with 4 points. That brings the score to 55 points for Central City, plays Kallio's 33.
Still not much in it, really, considering the we've not really had any massive jams so far. What I'll do is I'll just take a second to think about that while staring at Riggs and see if Riggs can just quickly tell me what the highest jam's been so far. So that last one was the highest jam score we've had. So not a massive scoring game in terms of jam scores. So we'll see if this last 6 minutes of this first period changes that, as we've got Not Sorry Laurie and E. Karpov. And again, we're back to this struggle for this first 20 feet of track. Not Sorry Laurie through for lead. Kallio just one blocker down as Kallio's L is now coming out of the box, going to come and rejoin the pack. Now we're getting back to this split defense, three wall holding. E. Karpov at the front. Well, we've got a three wall at the back with some offense for Central City, but right now this pack is moving like treacle. It's not moving at all on the track. We're not getting any forward movement. Everything's just kind of side by side. Every inch has been fought for by the jammers.
Not Sorry Laurie is working hard on that outside line and was almost through, but oh, There's Guy Karpov successfully outmaneuvering the central city pivot.
So they were probably the four hardest points earned in this game.
Definitely. 4 points for Central City, and it took almost the entire 2 minutes.
And that jam felt like it, the amount of effort that went there should have been scored like 50 points aside, but 4 points only for that amount of effort. But yeah. We're getting 5 minutes left in this first period. Both these teams have been fighting hard, so they're bound to be slowing up the pace a little bit and getting into that more... The slower game that we're seeing, this tight packed game, as we've got L for Central City against QT for Kallio. L rolling round L and L picks up a forearm. That's Kallio's L, while Central City's L is now out for lead. Okay, I think we need a unique naming system again.
Yeah. Well, on paper, they do have unique names.
Yeah, on paper they do.
Unfortunately, they're pronounced the same. And that is a star pass for Kallio. Star has been taken by Lionheart. And with that, we see Central City's L calling off the jam. 4-0 in this previous jam. Score is sitting at 63 for Central City and 38 for Kallio. And we're going to... talk to you a bit more about our lovely sponsors, because have you tried the Atom Savant wheels? Well, see what you've been missing at atomskates.com.
And we've got Dr. Knock picking up lead for Central City. Teabag, meanwhile, just being held up, finally managed to break as Dr. Knock gets into the first scoring trip and makes it look easy. Picks up the 4 points. So we went from 4 points in the entire jam to 4 points in 20 seconds.
Yeah.
We can't have it all the ways here, but we're certainly trying.
Yeah, that's for sure. So far, Central City took the lead right off the bat and are still running with it. We're nearing the close of the first half. And, well, if you look at the... stats and the seeding of this tournament, this is not quite the game you'd expect.
So we're going to look at Weston Super Clare. He's going to be pushing forward, picks up lead for Central City. Pusa being held up the back by Bunny Massacre.
Kallio is one defender down as the pivot takes a seat in the box.
Weston Superclair gets through the pack, picks up the four. Meanwhile, Pusa still just being held up. Their star is off. However, the pivot is in the box standing now, so no star pass going to happen. So all Central City do is keep the eye on who the jammer currently is.
But that can also be an effective strategy to just remove the star and... Oh!
Weston Superclair tried the apex jump. Now we get the star pass, and this is going to be to Lionheart for Kallio. Came out of the box, picked up the star, but again, Central City with the shutout. Central City racking up 8 points in that jam, 75 plus 38, less than a minute left of period one of this year, game three, at the WFTDA European Continental Cup 2019.
So Central City is on a scoring streak, holding Kallio scoreless for the past four jams.
Not sorry, Laurie, and Karma Satura. Karma Satura makes the initial moves. Not sorry, Laurie, being held up by Aika Helpo and Vatu Vima at the back of the pack. No pack is called. I think we're going to see a penalty issued to Victoria Kudawu for the block put onto Karma Satura, and now we've got Karma Satura through to pick up lead for Kallio. Not sorry, Laurie has removed the star, looking for the star pass to Mascara, but Karma Satura came through and put the block into Mascara. So now Not Sorry Laurie retains the star, carries on as Jammerin is out on the initial pass.
Jam time, period clock has run out, so we're running on jam time now. Oh, Jammer's picking up points now. How long are Kallio gonna run it?
And Kallio pick up three to finish that jam with 7 points to four in the jam. That brings a 45 to 79 in favor of Central City as we go to halftime.
So this has been an exciting first half here in Helsinki. And I must say, I'm quite excited to see what, like, if Central City can keep this pace up and keep this scoring up, or if Kallio has a really good halftime chat and figures out a way to contain and defend.
Yeah, I think if Central City can keep on just getting the lead and doing what they're doing, you know, getting a few points and shutting it down, and then stop Kallio from getting control of the jams and racking up some big points, I think Central City have got this. Just going by this performance, if Kallio can come out and can start taking control of the game, they can just, you know, that first 10, 15 seconds of each jam, if they can concentrate on getting the lead and controlling it and they can stop that shutout, they can run the jams as long as they want. But I think we've seen Central City with the lion's share of lead going throughout the game. And when they've had lead, they've used it really effectively. They've held Kallio scoreless a lot of the time.
Yeah, and you're absolutely right about the lead. Central City is sitting on 13 leads and Kallio with 8 leads. So that's...
The views have been effective, but we've got about 13.5 minutes of half time now where Kallio will be in their locker room discussing how they're going to come out and fight back. So we're going to go to some words from our sponsors. And while we do that, you get ready for the second period of this game three from the WFTDA European Continental Cup 2019. Welcome back to game three here at the European Continental Cup in Helsinki, Finland. Once again, I'm Sven, and I'm here with Riverain, and we've got Riggs out of shot, just kind of, again, doing all the mathematics and pointing and, you know, saying things to us and making us feel good. So we're here, obviously, Central City versus Kallio. Central City have got the lead right now, 79-45. Have we got any interesting facts and stats? Have you been crunching some numbers?
Well, Riggs has been. It has been very wonderful. So we talked about how we haven't really seen any high scoring jams. That's true. That 9-point jam is still the highest scoring jam. Each team has had a power jam apiece, so that's not where the score differential comes from. Central City's number 99, Western Super Clear, is still sitting on a 100% lead percentage. So
one of the things I know is, just looking back at the regular season, Kallio, Ikarpov has been one of their strongest jammers, highest points per jam, average about 4.1 points per jam, all the way through the regular season. I think, if I'm looking at the sheet here, held scoreless all the way through the first period.
Yep, that is just about right.
So Kallio's strongest jammer through the regular season is being held scoreless by Central City, and that could be part of the way that they're holding this lead, is by locking down on the Kallio, like, jammers that they've got in such a way that, you know, they're not letting them get out and get the rack up the points per jam.
And it will be interesting to keep an eye on who the jammer matchups are going to be, like, how are they matching Ikarpov?
Well, looks like we're back to where we started jam one of period one with Not Sorry Lori versus Kamasatura. However, this time it's Kamasatura who's got lead for Kallio and is already in on a scoring trip. Just muscles the way past Mascara. Kallio out now. 4 points picked up. Already now kind of showing that they're back into this second period. Little apex step. Meets Mascara and Jellymean. Now just being held up as the pack stops on the penalty box straight.
Back to a standstill. Oh, there we go. Sneaky star pass out for Central City. Over to Pivot 197. That's Mascara.
Mascara took a star pass early on in the first period. Wasn't able to do much with it, and again, not able to do anything with the star pass. This time gets shut out. And we're going to come now to a matchup between 895L for Central City against number 9 Teabag from Kallio. Full house of blockers on the track as we get underway with Jam 2 of Period 2. Teabag going left then right, just trying to get through between Gemma Harvey and Bunny Massacre. As we lose Harris to the penalty box, now Kallio's L is recycling Central City's L back behind the jam line.
Up front, well, Teabag almost out, taken to the infield by Trouble, but that, I do believe that earned Trouble a trip to the penalty box. Both jammers out of the pack now.
But it was enough for L to get through and pick up the lead for Central City. Takes a big hit and calls off the jam in the air. 2 points go on the board for Central City. Once again, just being able to shut out Kallio.
And that's really all they want to do. It seems like they have a very clear idea of what they're going for. They're just picking up 2 points, 4 points, sometimes just 1 point, but then shutting down Kallio and shutting down Yi Karpov as well.
So very slow start, very almost stopped in the jam line. We get Dr. Nock and Pusa, but Pusa finds a space to get through, picks up lead for Kallio. Dr. Nock just being held back by Watavima. Pusa now on the first scoring trip for Kallio. Got Mascara and Victoria Kudamu to beat, but gets through, picks up another 4 points for Kallio now. Starting to bridge that gap, whereas Dr. Nock still held on the initial pass. Dr. Nock barely made 15 feet in this jam so far of forward progress.
But we have an empty box, all skaters back on track, which means there could be some spare resources to try and play offense for Dr. Nock.
No one coming back yet to aid. Harris is there poised. Looks like Harris is going to try and open the inside line for Dr. Nock.
And there was a good opening on the inside, but it was just quickly sealed up again in front by Kallio's defense.
And Harris switched from offense to defense to actually make a move on Pusa to recycle Pusa back. Now Dr. Nock being held up and recycled by Macho Bichu. And once again, we get to a slow pack. Dr. Nock now start off. He's going to be looking for the pass to Treble as Pusa is through for another pass. Still 30 seconds remaining in the jam, however.
But that is 8 on the board for Pusa so far, and time to make some more. So this could be the highest scoring jam of the game.
So it looks like Pusa's got at least 2 legitimate passes. So that's gonna be the highest scoring jam of the game. And we're still only 12 points in.
Uh-oh, and we're gonna start the next jam with a power jam for Kallio. That was a forearm penalty assessed to Dr. Nock. And I'd like to give a shout out to Rydell Skates. They're the proud sponsor of the 2019 WFTDA Playoffs and Championships. Thank you, Rydell. Go to rydell.com to read more.
And now we've got E-Karpov on the power jam for Kallio. Now we've got a pack that's moving, but it's working in E-Karpov's favour as the line has opened up through turn two, allowing E-Karpov to get through and pick up lead. Kallio just making Central City stretch at the front. And it looks, I think there may have been a no pack there because we've got a destruction penalty being issued to move from Kallio.
Yeah, that is Mui in the box. And Mui is already up on four penalties, which is the highest number of penalties for any skater so far in the game. We're really in a standstill here in turn three again.
Yeah, so we've gone back to the stuck-in mode gameplay here. No one wants to give up any forward momentum. And we've got a brace there of treble, Gemma Harvey and Bunny Maska.
Ooh!
Just been wiped out by Lionheart, came in to open up that space. Took all three Central City blockers off the track.
Yeah, knocked the wind out of some of them as well, it looked like. E-Karpov with only one to beat and gets through for 4 points. Treble up in the front, trying to contain E-Karpov.
So a 15-point jam as we get a team timeout called by Central City.
And then that becomes the highest scoring jam so far.
So, period two has now turned into a completely different game, as we're now reset 80 players, 81. Kallio just 1 point adrift from Central City now, with just 7.5 minutes of the second period played. Whatever was said in that Kallio locker room is certainly working wonders.
Yes, indeed, because we started this period with a differential of 34 points in favor of Central City. So, I mean, that's a good catch-up by Kallio.
Well, 27 of those points have come in the last two jams
from
Kallio. So, I mean, I say the last two jams. We've only had four jams.
We're only four jams in.
And 3 out of 4 leads in favor of Kallio. It's showing how kind of getting that control is what we said. If they can get control, they can run the jams the way they want them. They can pull this back, and they have done that. So now we're back in, again, much closer game. Not sorry, Laurie, against, Kamasatura lined up. I can just see the three. It's 3-1, Kamasatura, and it looks like we're ready for a slow start as everyone's gathered on this jam line, but Kamasatura rolls and finds the inside line, picks up lead for Kallio.
Kamasatura taking advantage of that slow start by just outpacing everybody. Oh, coming in hot on the first scoring pass. And the crowd goes wild up in here as we have an official lead change for Kallio.
But we are getting plenty of penalties, and we've now got a power jam. Central City cut track picked up by Kamasatura. So now we're going to go the remainder, 1 minute 20 of the jam. Not sorry, Laurie. Out and able to get into a scoring trip.
Makes short work of the Kallio defense.└================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================�================�================================================================================================================================================================�================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================�================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================================ A slight increase in the lead for Central. Four more picked up by Not Sorry Laurie, but Kamasutura is out of the box, back on track, back in play.
Welcome to back, Bridges. Central City, double post tripod. Works it out with the
And this is going to be the first 2-minute jam of the game now. lead status being lost by Karma Satura.
Four more for Not Sorry Laurie, bringing them up to 16 points picked up so far. That's the highest scoring gem for Central City, and Not Sorry Laurie is not even done yet.
So a different style of gameplay altogether now, as we get Central City replying to Kallio with a 19 point jam, highest of the game. So now we're starting to get the jams getting stretched out. We're getting some higher score lines coming up in these jam matchups. So we're going to see now Kallio with the one blocker advantage as we get L for Central City lining up against T-Bag for Kallio. L just being able to muscle past Kallio's L, picks up lead. But we've got T-Bag out half a lap behind as Central City's L comes up now into turn one, tries to take the entire route, rolls off, calls off the jam.
No points picked up by... Yup, there was one finger held up by the jam ref. 1 point for Central City in that jam. So Central City sitting at 101, Kallio at 88, and up next it is Dr. Knock and Pusa.
Pusa shrugs off a block from Jellybean but gets picked up by Mascara at the front. Dr. Knock meanwhile is being held up by Watavima. And we have got Pusa out with lead for Kallio. Star pass to Mascara. Second star pass of the period to Mascara. And Pusa able to pick up 1 point before calling off the jam.
So we had like some big jams and then 2 1-point jams right after another.
We've got an official timeout. Yeah, so it looks like I think there's an issue with the scoreboard that we're just going to quickly rectify. So we've gone to an official timeout. Look at that.
Which means that I'm here to tell you a little bit about our lovely sponsors. Experience world-class edging with the number one wheel in Derby, Radar Halo. So check out the Radar wheels in the Rydell family at rydell.com.
So Western Superclare still on 100% lead, and Western Superclare is going to be lined up, it looks like, for the next jam against E. Karpov.
Yes, indeed.
And we're just... I'm not sure what exactly the issue is with the scoreboards. I think, so we've got two scoreboards in the venue here. There's one that the crowd can see, and there's one that's pointed for the benches to see. And I think there was a discrepancy between the two scoreboards. So we had two different, obviously, since both teams are going to look at the scoreboards in terms of the timing and the scores, we've got to make sure they are in sync, because if one bench is looking at one scoreboard rather than another, you know, they could affect the way the game's going. So obviously we're just making sure that those two scoreboards are running in sync.
Yeah, sort out all the technical issues. So in terms of penalties, both teams are quite even in the spread of them. 16 penalties for Kallio, 14 penalties on Central City, and they're quite evenly spread out. Not much to say about that. We can say that the Kallio crowd, the Kallio fans are... (Laughs) there are many, but Central City are louder. Well, while we're waiting for the action here, let me just remind you real quick that championships are coming up. So get your tickets to the 2019 International WFTDA Championships in Montreal. It's November 15th to 17th, and you can go to wftda.com/champs and get some. There are many fun experiences awaiting you in Montreal, like chicks and bowls, shred sessions, Team Indigenous, and Jewish roller derby. We are nation.
We have some issues with the scoreboards. We are restarting the programs, and we'll return to the game soon. Thank you.
Okay, there. So they're having to restart the actual scoreboard software and put another euro coin in the electric meter to keep it all running. So we'll resume with the game as soon as we can get these technical difficulties out the way.
And we are 2.5 games in to this tournament, this Cups tournament, which means there was an official bracket competition, which Antwerp smashed earlier this morning. And there are only 15 intact brackets left.
Yep, that's roller derby. You can never 100% predict anything, but with roller derby, when you come into a tournament like this after a regular season, you don't know how much the teams want this, how much they value these games, and how much, you know, just the experience of playing here pushes them to often, you know, override the stats and the facts and the figures and the seedings and the rankings and all that. And that's what we saw in that first game, which was a phenomenal game. And then obviously the next game between Perth and Ulriki has been phenomenal. And I say this one's shaping up to be the same. So obviously, you know, Central City here are the number 6 seed, currently leading by 12 points over Kallio, the number 3 seed. 19 place ranking difference between the two teams. But it just goes to show you that when the teams get this level of play, all the predictions, all the brackets go out the window when they start playing like this.
Indeed, and especially since this is such a small bracket, we only have 8 teams playing this weekend, which means every game counts for almost so much more, since the competition is fierce. I wonder if that's an incentive to just churn it up to the maximum.
And still to come in the thing, talking about the 8 teams, we've got 2 more teams that you've not seen yet in Helsinki here, which is at 3 p.m. Obviously, that's 3 p.m. local time. Check your time calculator of choice to work out what the time is in your area. But with the 3 p.m., we've got Game 4, which is Tiger Babe Rollers against Dock City Rollers, who are 2 teams I love watching, especially after the Continental Cup of Europe last year in Telford. Watching those 2 teams play really kind of opened my eyes to the way they play. And I've seen Dock City a few times in some various other tournaments. I love watching them play. I can't wait to see them go head-to-head again in the next matchup, Game 4. And that's coming up, say, at 3 p.m. Obviously, at the moment, we're just kind of, say, sorting out some technical difficulties that we've got. We've got to make sure that we've got the scoreboards and the accurate game clocks in place for the teams to work from. But we've had the rolling whistle, so it looks like we're ready to go back into the action with Western Superclay lining up against E. Karpov.
Yes, indeed. 18 minutes left of the game. If you are just tuning in now, it is Kallio playing in the black. It is Central City playing in pink. Score is sitting at 101 for Central and 89 for Kallio. And we are live with the action.
And we'll try and keep you updated with the scores and times. But as we've got now, Yi Karpov is through, picks up the lead for Kallio.
A quick apex step there for Yi Karpov. Tries to dip on the outfield to get past. Doesn't quite make it. Is recycled. Is that? Western Super Claire with star in hand. Nope, gets through, gets the star back on, and is going for the first scoring trip.
So it looks like we've returned to a technical building. You've got the overlay on your screen now showing you the Kallio or 92, Central City or 101 points. And in that jam, Western Super Claire lost the 100% lead record. So now we're going to see what Not Sorry Laurie and Cutie can do for their respective teams as we go to another slow start to the jam. Haven't got past 10 feet yet with the pack.
Not Sorry Laurie trying to move the Helsinki defense, but that's KO, that's Vappu Vimma, and that is Aika Helku, and they are not moving. And Kuti is out for lead for Kallio.
Not Sorry Laurie just pulls the line against that hit from Machu Picchu, completes the initial pass for Central City as Kuti calls off the jam. 3-point pickup for Kallio, shutting out Central City, bringing us now to a 6-point game. Still 16 minutes of this second period of game three left to play.
So the game is open. Central held scoreless for the past three jams, with Kallio just chipping away.
Bear in mind, in the first period, Kallio only held Central City scoreless to three jams in the entire period. Three in the first 40 minutes is showing that they're stepping up the game as we go into this period two. Teabag fighting past Treble and Harris, but it looked like that was Gemma Harvey with the hit to push Teabag to the infield.
Teabag. Teabag manages to grab lead, is recycled, successfully steps in, and is on a scoring trip.
So L has the star in hand, just being held at the back of the pack here, going into turn two. L from Kallio with the recycle, going all the way back to turn one. At the front of the pack though, Bunny Massacre supported by Gemma Harvey and Harris. Again, making it a real effort to try and pass that wall.
The hard-earned 4 points picked up by Teabag there. And we are almost, I'm gonna hold my tongue just a little bit to be absolutely sure.
Cut track picked up by L for Central City, so power jam in favor of Kallio now. Teabag with lead, 18 seconds or so remaining on the clock. Gets it called to call it off, so Kallio gonna have the power start. As we are now tied game.
1-0-1 plays 1-0-1, tied game with 13 minutes on the clock. Kallio has dominated this second half with long lead streaks and keeping Central City scoreless. Central have only picked up 2 leads so far.
And now we've got Ekarpov on power jam. Picks up lead for Kallio.
Looks like Ekarpov has got the groove back.
No, because it was so fast.
Karpov sitting on a 100% lead record in the second period so far. 4-for-4. KO coming up on the offense now, trying to open up the space for Ekarpov. KO just trying to stop Central City from getting a wall built. 13. And we're back to slow play, rolling into turn three. Kallio just opening up some space, moves Mascara, moves Victoria Kudawu. Millie Idol and Victoria Kudawu just get E. Karpov to the outside, recycle back to the entrance of turn three. Aika Helpo picks up a direction as we have L for Central City with the star stashed. Mascara is up on the offense for Central City. Just moves Watovima. Looks like direction of gameplay for Mascara though, so no offense now for L. No pack is called. Watovima rolls L all the way back.
KO for Kallio, working like a wrecking ball here. Just taking out the Central City defense left and right.
So again, 4 points picked up by Kallio in that jam. It seemed like there should be more.
I felt like, again, that was a lot of hard work right in front of us for 4 points. But it does put Kallio in the lead with 105 points versus Central City's 101. 10 minutes on the clock and we are back in the action.
Western Superclair and Pusa. Pusa goes round the outside of the wall. He gets quickly absorbed into the center of the pack. Western Superclair is being held up by Mew and L. As we get Mascara coming from the box for Central City, going to open up some offense. Rolls around the front. Pusa just takes a hit from Gemma Harvey. Now held up behind Western Superclair, who's removed the star. So Mascara has got the pivot stripe on, so if there's going to be a star pass, it will be going to Mascara. As we get L for Kallio, picks up the forearms call.
Pusa manages to make it through the pack with 4 points and the audience is loving it. But Western Superclair is right on their heels. And the pack has just gone for a run. Pusa catching up with the back of the pack. Takes a tumble here in the turn and calls it off. Not quite fast enough. That's going to be 3 points for Western Superclair and Central City. That brings us to a score of 109 for Kallio, 104 for Central City. This is exciting.
Oh, yeah. So, 5 point game, nearly 9 minutes remaining. Kallio with the lead now. Not Sorry Laurie and Kama Sutura. Not Sorry Laurie tries to come back to track but sees Watovima. They're just waving the arms to say, hey, you're going to cut on me if you come back now. So has to recycle.
Cut track assessed to Kama Sutura. This is going to be a power jam for Not Sorry Laurie.
So Not Sorry Laurie has dropped the star but has been recovered by Mascara, who's holding it at the front. Now the star has gone back to Not Sorry Laurie. So we're not going to have a lead in this jam.
That's right, and it's going to be another 2 minute jam.
Unless, of course, the star came from Not Sorry Laurie's helmet as a result of natural gameplay, in which case, you know, Not Sorry Laurie could put it back on and gain lead at this point, I believe.
Technically, yes. Although I am not sure that is what happened. It looked like a stash, I believe. Oi.
But we have had the star pass to Maz Skara. It's the third star pass that Maz Skara has taken this period, forcing the game. Now we get the first point for Maz Skara on the board.
Maz Skara picks up all four. 1 point game so far. We're just gonna have to wait for the clock to run out to see how this plays off, but both jammers scoring. And that's gonna be a forearm assist to Kamasutra again. So power jam for Maz Skara and Central City.
And Victoria Kuduwu picks up a forearm penalty as well, right in the end of that jam.
We've got the last points ticking in on the board now. There you have it. 1-1-1 plays 1-1-1. Tied game at 6 minutes left. Oi! Well, a quick shout out to derbywithoutborders.org. Check out Derby Without Borders to see how you can help support the growth of roller derby around the world. Remember to bring your donations to 2019 champs.
And we've got L for Central City, picks up lead. And we've got Kamasutura still sitting in the penalty box. Now standing, so 10 seconds left on the penalty as L is going to try and push out the lead here that they are gaining back out of this game. Now we've got penalty ended for Kamasutura. Looking for the star pass to L for Kallio. Just being held at bay by Gemma Harvey. Now we've got the star pass, so it's L versus L.
Oh, I'm so glad this happened. L versus L.
L for Kallio now in after the initial trip. L for Central City letting the jam roll on. Just gets bumped to the inside by Mu.
L for Central City out of the pack there with 4 points. L from Kallio still trying to work past the Central City defense here in turn two. It's taken out to the infield.
Now it looks like Mu is taking L all the way back to the pivot line. That's Central City's L, of course.
Well, this is just delightfully confusing.
This is one of those jams that'll make a lot more sense on the Twitter feed. Mm-hmm. So now we've got Kallio's L gets through for a 4 point pickup. However, Central City's L is sitting with 12 already. So you're gonna see what goes up. Another 4 goes up for Central City's L. So 16 point jam to 4 point jam. Gives us a 12 point difference now. Kallio sitting on 115 points, Central City on 127. 4 minutes left of this game.
12 points between these two teams. Winner goes to the semifinals.
So Dr. Nock tried to push Teabag off the track right from the start, picked up a forearm penalty, which means it's effectively a power start now for Kallio with a 2-blocker advantage, as we're now 4-on-2 in the pack. Power jam in favor of Kallio. Teabag picks up the first 4 points. Now we get the penalty box empty for Central City as Bunny Massacre and Treble are coming back, but they're going to be drawn all the way back to the pivot line by Watavima.
4 more points picked up by Teabag. We're gaining. Kallio's gaining on Central City here.
Power jam ends with Dr. Nock returning to the track. Star in hand. Treble is the pivot.
But the Central City jammer is still on the initial pass, so we're not scoring points just yet. Teabag working on the third scoring trip. There we go. 127, place 127. We still have 2 minutes of game left. We're not done with this jam.
So Dr. Knock takes Teabag back. It looks like we've had a star pass to Treble.
Yep.
Yep, so Treble now has a star on helmet.
Still, oh.
Treble has left the pack, but left the star behind on turn three. So Treble is out on the initial pass, but not the active jammer.
But...
and we get a team timeout called by Central City. Kallio now taking the lead, 131 to 127, with 1 minute and 44 remaining on the clock.
Some quick math, that's 4 points separating these two teams and a place in the semifinals.
Oh.
You look like you need to catch your breath, Sven.
Yep. These last few jams have just been very nice to watch.
Yeah.
But when you look at the scoreline, you know, 1 minute 44 left and it's this tight. And the way these two teams have been playing all game as well, when it's going to come down to one or maybe two jams remaining, I'm not going to make any predictions right now. I'm going to say that. I'm going to be, if there's a fence, I am the most on the fence person there is.
I think that's a very sound place to be right now, because this game has gone back and forth so much that essentially... we're just going to have to wait and see.
In years to come, there'll be an Oscar-winning documentary called Man on Fence about me and this game right now.
Can't wait to see it.
So we're going to have Not Sorry Laurie lining against E. Karpov. 4-on-4 in the pack, all huddled on the jam line. Both jammers push for the center. Not Sorry Laurie moves to the outside. E. Karpov takes a bump from Victoria Kudowu. Gets held up now between Victoria Kudu and Bonnie Massacre. And we got a forearm call on Victoria Kudu. We're getting penalty whistles going, another forearm as well. This time that forearm is going to go to Kallio's shenanigans.
So 3-on-3 in the pack with the Kallio defense in the front of the apex. But that is... Yi Karpo just stepping past the entire pack in the apex to pick up lead for Kallio. On a scoring trip now, smooth sailing on the outside for 4 points.
Not Sorry Laurie removes the star, but Mascara, sorry, Treble is in the box. In fact, we've now got a power jam. Kallio, as Not Sorry Laurie picks up a cut track. 49 seconds on the jam clock, 1 minute, sorry, 45 seconds on the period clock, 1 minute on the jam clock. So more time on the jam clock than we've got on the period clock here. E. Karpov in control and on the power jam. But now we're back to 4-on-4 in the pack. But now Kallio are pushing their lead over Central City. 139 versus 127 as the power jam ends. Not Sorry Laurie coming back to track right now.
And in the last four jams have been jammer penalties, have been power jams, because we've seen jammer penalties in all of them. And the clock is just ticking here. Kallio's bench is saying go, go, go. And there comes the call-off signal.
So the unofficial final score, Central City 127, Kallio 142.
That's... quite a halftime talk that Kallio had, because we ended the first half with a 34-point lead for Central City.
Yeah.
And Kallio then just came out of that break and came back and just
and I think it
got
was,
to work.
I can't even speak anymore. It was just such a change in Kallio, and look at the lead stats they had. So I think there was four jams where Kallio did not have lead. I think one of those was no lead. So Kallio dominated that just in terms of controlling the game. And that's what we said. If Kallio can come out of after first period, if they can come into this and control the game belongs to them.
And they did, in fact, control it in more ways than one, because in the first half, they were a bit heavier on penalties, not by much, but just a little bit, and they did not get the lead. Central City was dominating on the lead, but here in the second half, Central City did pick up a lot more penalties, and Kallio just reined in their penalty counts. So effectively, you have your skaters on track for more time actually doing the blocking.
It was Kallio holding the lead and pushing the jams out, was forcing Central City to make the mistakes, and that's what then obviously they've capitalized on that, and they've really pushed it. And although those last few jams were really tight, then Kallio did such a good job to bring it from where they were going into that period to where they have ended. And obviously, well-deserved winners. But number three seed versus number six seed, you're not expecting the games to be that tight. And look at the game we've just had there.
Yeah, but I mean, we started the morning off with the bottom seed upsetting the top seed. So I feel like this tournament is open for anything.
And speaking of open for anything, next game up, we've got game four of the European Continental Cup, which is going to see Tiger Bay Brawlers facing off against Dock City Rollers. That's coming up at 3 p.m. Yeah, 3 p.m. Helsinki time. Obviously, say check your local listings and schedules to know what time that is wherever you live. But just know that it's the next game up here from the WFTDA European Continental Cup 2019 from Helsinki in Finland.